Australia is home to some very weird animals, from little thorny devils to big furry ones that stink. You'll be surprised by some of their weird and wonderful habits and adaptations. Let's take a look. First up is the Moloch horridus, or thorny devil. This reptile is so unique that it is the only species of its kind. With spiky desert-coloured scales, they effortlessly disappear into the arid zones of Australia. Sharp spines and a false head on the back of their neck provide defence against predators like birds and goannas. Meanwhile, they prefer to eat ants, thousands of them every day. Not shy of a wardrobe change, they alternate between lighter scales in summer and darker in winter. Perfect for cooling down or warming up. Those thorns aren't just for looks either. Together they form a series of channels to carry morning dew and ground moisture down to the mouth. Hundreds of years ago, scientists couldn't quite believe this Australian animal was real. They were convinced an egg-laying mammal with a duck's bill, beaver's tail, and otter's feet was a complete joke. Introducing the very real platypus with some impressive adaptations. With an estimated 40,000 electroreceptors built into its bill, the platypus is a lean, mean, food-finding machine. These help it detect yabbies, shrimp, insect larvae, and worms in murky rivers. Don't be fooled by this placid creature just because you aren't on the dinner menu. Built-in venomous spurs on the hind feet of males are deadly to small animals and known to cause excruciating pain. It's best not to get too close to this quirky creature. Echidnas are part of a very rare mammal club. Along with the platypus, they are the only kinds of monotremes in the world. Unlike most mammals, monotremes lay eggs instead of birthing live young. Slightly less picky than the thorny devil, the short-beak echidna uses its long snout to find delicious ants and termites. With digging claws at the front and scooping feet at the back, they can dig out their favourite snack with ease. When threatened, echidnas will also dig to seek protection. If that's not possible, they will curl up in a spiky ball. If their predator, like a goanna, is especially keen, then they can even extend their spines and wedge themselves in rock crevices. Now that's clever. From a disturbing screech, serious lack of table manners, and an incredibly bad body odour, this marsupial has some very unusual habits. The Tasmanian devil is not fussy about what it eats. Prey that is sick, dead, or alive can all meet its bone-crushing jaws. It also has no problem stealing from other carnivores. Unfortunately, their love of an easy dinner includes roadkill. Finding dinner on the side of the road is not safe for any animal, and many Tasmanian devils suffer the same fate as their last meal. Surprisingly fast runners and strong swimmers, the young are especially good at climbing trees. This could be a result of hungry adults eating their young. As the second tallest bird in the world, after the ostrich, the emu can grow up to 1.9 metres high. Their claim to large bird fame most definitely doesn't include their wings, which only grow to 20 centimetres in length. With an attitude to match their height, these flightless birds rule the outback. Clever adaptations mean they can be found right across Australia. An extra set of transparent eyelids protect their eyes from dusty environments. This is especially useful in the outback, where they are known to travel long distances to feed on plants and insects. With unpredictable water supplies, they know how to drink to survive. A good continuous drink can last up to 10 minutes. There are not a lot of predators for the emu, but if they do encounter one, like a dingo, their sharp claws and impressive kick are built to injure. Which animal do you think is the weirdest? And which one would you like to meet? Or perhaps not?